Lisa Wilkinson, who's most impressively, I believe, read every single one of those books behind her on the bookshelf during this period of isolation.
And my husband has written every single one of those books quietly.
That's very true.
But I have been working, as you mentioned, and this week I jumped on a Zoom call with Natalie, Emily and Marty, who make up the band known as the Dixie Chicks. Now they're just called the Chicks, and they remain one of the most successful country music bands of all time. And now they are back with all of that same fire we've come to love them for and a brand new album.
When your debut record becomes the best-selling album in country music history, there's a certain pressure to back it up. Since first hitting superstardom, they've sold more than 30 million records and have had to find room in their cabinet for 13 Grammys, 10 CMAs, 6 Billboard Music Awards, 4 AMAs. Yeah, they're gonna need a bigger cabinet. Last album was released in 2006 before the band took a short 14-year break, and now they're back with Gaslighter.
This is your first studio album since 2006. Of course, it won a swag of Grammys. And then nothing. What happened?
Well, a lot of kids. We had 9 kids between the three of us, so we kind of needed to, you know, do the mom thing full time for a while. Then they all became teenagers and we said, let's go make an album.
The Dixie Chicks announced their new name.
They say they're just going to be going by The Chicks.
The Dixie Chicks are no more. Dixie is a slang word for America's southern states, especially those that were pro-slavery. And it's a change the band's been wanting to make for some time.
So we've wanted to change it, especially since 2003. And it just always seemed too much to take on with our success. And just after George Floyd's murder and all these changes that are going on, I think for the better, it was just the perfect time and enough was enough. We didn't even have to discuss it. We were ready to change. And the Chicks is such a cooler name anyway. We're happy.
While their success has been huge, so have the controversies, including the time Nat criticised then-President George W. Bush.
We're ashamed the President of the United States is from Texas.
The uproar over the Dixie Chicks
quickly fell from the top of the charts.
They should send Natalie over to Iraq, strap her to a bomb, and just drop her over Baghdad.
I liked them, you know, but for what they said, it's trash.
We don't plan, you know, what we're going to say on stage or anything like that. So I'm sure I knew I was going to address it because it was something so huge that was looming over the world. But I, yeah, just thought I was being entertaining. But I do feel like we were some of the early examples of how people organizing on the internet can have a lot of power. I was just being honest and being me, and I don't think I said anything wrong. I think I was right. I was right to have an opinion regardless, but I also think I was right about the lies about weapons of mass destruction and the excuse we were using to invade another country.
Have meant to be a political band then, but they sure are now, and they're not shying away from it on this new album.
When the Black Lives Matter movement got so much more intensified here in this country, and the label was asking us to put out another song, it was just so obvious that March March needed to come out, because it is in general about standing up for what you believe in and taking to the streets and making your voice heard. So it seemed very timely.
Who's worse, Bush or Trump?
Oh gosh, definitely Trump. Oh my gosh. Yeah, you make Bush W just look like my best friend.
Well, my words to George W. Bush weren't even that strong. I just said I was ashamed he was from Texas. I have much stronger words for Trump on a daily, hourly, minute-by-minute basis. It's a disaster. I really feel like we're in true danger. I felt like we were in true danger when he was elected. And the fact that a pandemic is happening while he's in charge is just, couldn't be worse luck.
I feel like I should move on because, I mean,
we're about to have our second controversy.
Oh, yeah. We're all cheering you on.
The backlash to their controversy was so extreme that even record label execs warned a young Taylor Swift not to get political so as not to end up like the Chicks.
I mean, I don't feel like it's such a bad thing to end up like the Chicks. I feel pretty happy, pretty lucky.
You know, in our minds, Taylor Swift is always 19 years old. She's over 30 years old now. You know, everyone evolves. Everyone gets to a place where they, you know, want to start, you know, saying what they want to say. And she's been awesome to us, and we love her.
In addition to their new album, the Chicks have just dropped a brand new track called Sleep at Night.
Are you feeling excited after all these years putting out a brand new album?
I'm excited for people to hear it. I feel like we've been teasing it forever. You know, it was supposed to come out May 1st, so it's been hard to wait these 2.5 months. I'm just excited for people to have the record.
So, guys, I actually reckon they got the renaming of their band wrong. I think it should be A Great Bunch of Chicks. I absolutely loved having a chat with them. And the interesting thing is you heard there Nat saying that she's got a lot more that she could say about Trump. Well, she actually did say a lot more about Trump, but we decided trying to get it to air, we would have to go through such an army of lawyers that we had to do a little bit of this. But let's just say these girls are absolutely full of fire, and you'll see it all on display musically in Gaslighter, which is their brand new album.
Lise, great to see you. 3 more days of isolation. Take care of yourself. We'll see you on the other side.
Not that I'm counting. See you guys.
Oh, you heard it here first. They cut a lot of stuff. Slide into Lisa's DMs if you want to know what happened in the real version. She's at home for 3 days in quarantine. What else are you doing, Lisa?